and the wicked, and mine is not to reason why this is. In this I rest, in this I find my refuge, that my thoughts and ways are not his.
Well, hello, welcome to this Friday edition of Manna Minutes, and yay, the weekend is here. I hope this weekend that you are planning to make yourself a part of the local fellowship in Christ, meaning your local church body. If you don't have a place where you regularly attend, feel free to come over and join us at Joyful Manna Baptist Fellowship at 5075 North Raceway Road in Indianapolis. We're going to be continuing our series this weekend called Stronger Together. That'll be following the Sunday school at 10 a.m. and the worship service at 11. We're going to actually have ourselves an Italian style lunch, which is free, by the way, and then we're going to jump into the Word of God and take a look at the ways in which we can increase our interdependence with each other to the glory of God, to the edification of the saints, and to the uplifting of our community. So come join us for that. It's probably going to be a lot more fun than I just made it sound, and I hope I made it sound pretty fun. But today I want you to join me in a little exercise, and it's not that kind of exercise. You actually won't even have to put down your snack, and I know you're probably thinking, how did he know about the snack? Well, the secret is, I didn't know about a snack. I'm just playing on the odds of probability. Anyhow, join me in this little exercise, okay? It's a fill-in-the-blank exercise, and what I want you to do is I just want you to fill in the blank with the first word that comes to your mind, okay? So just be ready for that. Here we go. Life is not. Okay. Now, what did you fill in that blank with? And I know some of you may have to detract your statement because you said life is not a box of chocolates. And then you're like, wait a minute. No, life is a box of chocolates, right? But what did you fill it in with when you said life is not or life isn't? And many times that's, you know, well, life isn't a rose garden, or life is no bed of roses, or life is no picnic, or life is not fair. And how many of us have heard that one? There's not a lot of times when you can fill in that blank with something positive. Usually it's something that has a little bit of a negative tone to it. Well, let's take a look at that topic today in Psalm chapter 73, thinking about the fact that life is not fair. Jumping out in verse 1, the Bible says, "Truly God is good to Israel, to those who are pure in heart. But as for me, my feet had almost stumbled, for my steps had nearly slipped. For I was envious of the arrogant when I saw the prosperity of the wicked." Then down in verse 12, "Behold, these are the wicked, always at ease. They increase in riches. All in vain have I kept my heart clean and washed my hands in innocence. For all the day long I have been stricken and rebuked every morning." Do you ever identify with this statement? Do you ever feel like that the people who aren't trusting and relying on God, that they can just go on and everything is just smooth sailing and clear skies, and they can behave any way they want to and nothing bad ever happens to them, and they can just, you know, bad things never happen to bad people, right? And bad things always happen to good people. Well, that's not always the case, but I understand I've held that same perspective, and it crops up in my life. Well, honestly, more frequently than I wish that it did, where we look at everything that's going on around us and we say, it's just not fair. And I'm here to tell you today, without sugarcoating it, that yeah, that's true. Sometimes it's just not fair. Then the Bible says in verse 16, "But when I thought how to understand this, it seemed to me to be a wearisome task until I went to the sanctuary of God. Then I discerned their end. Truly, you set them in slippery places. You make them fall to ruin. How they are destroyed in a moment, swept away utterly by terrors, like a dream when one awakes." And you know, I want you to think about this, okay? Yeah, it's true that a lot of times the worst people seem to have the best luck, but don't concentrate on that. And the reason why I say don't concentrate on that is because here's what's going on in life. You have a heavenly Father who loves to be your strength, your defense, and your provider. If we never face obstacles that are bigger than us, then we never see the full sufficiency of God. Do you get that? Do you get that His strength is made perfect in our weakness? He's there for the problems that are bigger than we are. You know, the people who don't have that, they couldn't survive. They wouldn't even have a chance. They wouldn't have a prayer without the hope that you and I have. And God's not doing anything to show off His power for them, because truly, He's not with them. And when we think about where we live on this planet called Earth, right? And here we have the righteous and the unrighteous dwelling together. We have the elect and the non-elect, the regenerate and the non-regenerate, the saved and the unsaved, however you want to define that. And we all live here on this common ground called planet Earth. The good news for those of us who are known by Christ is this is the closest to hell that we're ever going to be. The bad news for them is this is the closest to heaven that they're ever going to be. Remember, it's the goodness of the Lord that leads us to repentance. And God disciplines every son whom He receives because He wants you to be conformed into the good image of Christ. And there's so many things that we don't learn without going through the trials. And one of those things is the full sufficiency of God. You know, those who don't have Him to cling to, they need the things of this life to cling to. But you and I, we have the Lord. As a matter of fact, that's clearly spelled out in the next part of this. In verse 23, it says, "Nevertheless, I am continually with you. You hold my right hand. You guide me with your counsel. And afterward, you will receive me to glory." Listen, if we face these trials in this life, they're just momentary. It's like a dream that you wake up from. And, you know, the years of this life, all the troubles together aren't worthy to be compared with the glory that will be revealed in us when we see Him face to face. So I want you to concentrate on that today and think about the fact that God is upholding you with His powerful right hand. And He is there just waiting to reveal His good pleasure on you for His glory and for your benefit. Then in verse 25, "Whom have I in heaven but you? And there is nothing on earth that I desire besides you. My flesh and my heart fail, but God is the strength of my heart and my portion forever. For behold, those who are far from you shall perish. You put an end to everyone who is unfaithful to you. But for me, it is good to be near God. I have made the Lord God my refuge, that I may tell of your works." Brothers and sisters, be encouraged today. Remember to be good, have fun, and do it in that order, and I'll look forward to seeing you tomorrow. Lord bless. Have you ever held a doubt? What this life is all about? Have you questioned all this?